We took 320 freshmen that were enrolled in the College Foundations class for Intermediate Algebra to St. Cloud State, and we toured a whole lot of buildings, and we saw a lot of their math departments, classrooms. We saw a lot of their science laboratories, some really cool stuff, actually.
This is my first time at a college campus. I thought it was really great. I mean, the campus is so nice. I love to search for new ones, but that campus is amazing.
Now I think I kind of know what to look for in a college. Like, that was kind of like just a medium sized. It wasn't too big. It wasn't too small. And I think that was like a pretty good size that I would like. So I think now, like, if I was going to go look for a college in the next couple of years, I'd kind of look like something more that size. Girl in the treetop looking at the stars, waiting for a touchdown coming in from Mars, thinking, hey, is there anybody out there?
Don't put that in the film.
There's a boy thinking of her playing his guitar.
I thought it was kind of cool how students actually kind of walked us around the campus for like the overall like just tour. What I liked about the trip to St. Cloud State was how it just widened my horizons on how affordable college can be.
Okay, Husky Tech Center fixes your laptop, tablets, phones, anything for free. It's all inclusive with the tuition.
I thought it was pretty cool that there's like tons of different buildings around. They had like the whole food court and everything. Then they had like the fitness whole building. There's a lot of different stuff on campus you could go to. It was really cool because I kind of got out of that. I never really knew what like a college campus was like. I just kind of thought like the classrooms were just like a big auditorium everyone sat in. But I kind of realized like there's a lot of smaller classes than that, like 20, 30 kids. And I just always thought that like classes were super huge.
So you'll notice John's apparatus is such that pendulum has the shortest string. So it goes over and back in the shortest amount of time. This next one is a little bit longer. So it goes over and back a little longer time period. And so on, all the way down to this end. That pendulum has the longest string and it will take the longest time to go over and back. When taken together, we find some very interesting and pleasing patterns. So, let me show you. Let me demonstrate. Are you ready? Can you hear them?
Yes.
Okay, thanks. So it's a snake.
That's so cool.
It's actually pendula sampling points on a traveling. Okay, these are just math words. It's pendula sampling points on a wave whose wavelength is continuously changing. It looks like a wave until it doesn't. Now, what does it look like? Just sort of lines. Lines crossing. Until it doesn't, and then it'll look like three lines. And then it'll actually look like a DNA molecule. Did you do biology yet? You know what a DNA molecule looks like, kind of?
Yes.
See if you can find it.
Yes.
Until it looks like two lines.
What?
What exactly? That's sick. Really. And then it'll start over again, go the other way around. It's basically first year physics applied to a gadget to make it fun. That's pretty much what we're looking at.
When it went into depth, it was like people who knew like everything on that stuff, like the one guy who showed us the pendulum and the clean room, and then they had people who were majoring and mastering in those fields when they were explaining stuff to us.
A physics student that just graduated, he was like talking with so much like passion for like his what he graduated in, and he was like, and he explained everything perfectly. He had like this huge smile on his face saying how, and that's how I want to be, you know, like talking about something that I love and that I graduated in. And I thought that college would be like, you know, this huge thing with like huge lecture halls and like 100 students for one teacher, but it's not. Like, it's just like here. It's like just a little bit bigger version of our school.
The answer buried in his heart, thinking, is there anybody out there?
I could picture myself there. I could picture myself like in the chemistry lab.
Because before, at the college fair that we had a couple weeks ago, St. Cloud wasn't even an option for me, but after I saw it and I saw the good science programs that they had, I finally decided I like these programs. They went over some of the stuff that I actually want to do, and so it just looked like a good fit for me.
Wishing we were young, hanging on the memory of what we would become, singing, I was born to be a rock star.
Students also got a chance to listen to a couple of St. Cloud State students talk about their experiences as a freshman. And they had some really great questions for those kids about what is homework like, what are classes like, what is life like when you're living on campus. That was pretty cool.
I really like talking to the college kids because like I like to just hear their point of view and like what they thought of college. And yeah, I think that was really helpful too.
When we came back to school, one of the coolest things I saw was that the kids were really kind of jazzed about getting back into their studies in math and in the rest of their classes, but especially in math, and making sure that they're on track to go to college. It really pumped them up as far as their goals to go to some sort of schooling after high school.
Well, now I kind of know that, like, well, I need this GPA or this ACT score. I know kind of how to prepare and, like, how good I have to be or what test scores I have to do to get into that college. It's totally changed my, like, thoughts about college. I never imagined it like that.
And even just being a ninth grader, like, I'm not sure exactly what I want to do with my life, but I can definitely start planning out.
I have a freshman here at Anoka High School who is in the Bridge to College program. He is a solid B to A student, but I think the College Foundation program has really motivated him. We have seen him really take ownership of his coursework. The St. Cloud State trip yesterday, he came home and was so excited about college, and he's already thinking in terms of that for himself now. So I see great value for a student like him to give him some context of why he's taking these classes in high school, why he needs to work, why this is important, and why it's good to aim high and to plan ahead. He is really fired up right now, is really feeling at home at Anoka, and made straight A's for the first time ever in his college, in his school career as a student ever, second trimester here at Anoka. So it's been a perfect fit for him, and we just really believe the College Foundation program has helped direct him.
I just wanna be a rock star. There's a boy in the backseat singing to this song, playing on the radio, knowing he's the one singing, I just wanna be a rock star. Singing, I was born to be a rock star. Looking at the stars, waiting for a touchdown, coming in from Mars, thinking, is there any